Okay, in this instructional video, we're going to take a look at the course shell and talk about basically what aspects of the course are contained here, and we'll get into a little bit about what the weekly routine will be for this class. This is, of course, the home page for the shell. There is a news section over here, which if anything that I need to let the entire class know about, I will post in here. Right now, obviously, there is a welcome message for you, so welcome to Intro to Sociology. Basically, where we can go from here, we'll go on to content, and at content, if we take a look at overview, we can see a copy of the course syllabus. So again, that'll give you a lot of information, again, about the course and how the grading is going. We'll take a look at that again in a minute. Some of the requirements of the course, such as quizzes, exams, discussion board, essay. We'll go over some of that, as well as the research evaluation. And then a breakdown of the schedule of modules, as well as, obviously, important information about academic dishonesty. I will let you take a look at this yourself. So anyway, you can at any time refer to the course syllabus right here in overview. We go down to this button, start here. Obviously, this is where we are right now here in this course navigation video. Hopefully, you've already viewed the About the Instructor, my welcome video. I'm going to take a look at some of these other ones in just a minute. The entire phase what we'll be looking at is the idea of starting with a typical module. Obviously, we're going to start with Module 1. And in Module 1, and each module is structured the same way, we can see that if we click on the overview, this will give us an idea about what will be conducted or what we hope to accomplish in this module. And if we take a look at the syllabus, we can see it roughly goes one module per week, with some exceptions for weeks that we will have exams. But in this, we can basically see these will be our goals of what we want to learn from this module. These are the activities contained within this module, and once again, these are our objectives, what we hope to gain from that. So if we go back, you can always check the overview just to be sure that we know exactly what it is that we're going to be addressing and trying to get out of it. Basically, where you would start, and we'll take a look at the weekly schedule in the next video, but if we take a look at where we start, the idea is just by clicking on the video lectures. Then by clicking on here, you'll be able to watch my presentation of the material. You should obviously also compare this with the reading that you're doing in the text, and also take notes about this material. If we take a look down, you can clearly see that depending on the module, there's a varying number of lectures. In these lectures, you can see that some of them are on the same topic that occurred in two parts. I've tried to keep the length of the lectures relatively small, usually around 20 minutes, so they can be watched in one sitting. You don't necessarily have to watch all of these in a row. You can certainly take time out or breaks between each of these, or watch them on consecutive sessions, that kind of thing. But at that point, as you can see down here, the next step in a typical module week would be to take the quiz that is about covered in the lectures. As we can see down here, the conditions that must be met in order to unlock the quiz is viewing the videos. So please do not attempt to access the quiz if you've not watched the videos. It will not allow you to do that. So once you've watched the videos and taken your notes, you'll be able to take the quiz. And again, if I were to click on that, mine would look different than yours, but you would click on the quiz, and once you completed these conditions, it will tell you exactly how to go about taking the quiz, and your quizzes will be automatically graded, and the grades go straight to the grade book, which we'll take a look at in just a minute. The other part of the next part, I should say, to a weekly module will be to engage in the weekly discussion. So basically, by clicking on this, you'll get the exact same assignment that we just saw before. But right here, it'll give you an example of, out of the material that we covered in the lectures, something that I would like you as a class to discuss. So once you've watched the videos, you could formulate your response to this discussion, and just by clicking on start a new thread, you'll be able to post your responses to that. And then, again, we'll take a look at the weekly schedule, we'll see what the deadlines for that are. But following the time that you post your discussion board response, of course, the rest of the class will be posting theirs as well. And then as other people's postings become available, you are expected to read those and give feedback, not just good job or I like what you said there, but you know, an engaging discussion. You may disagree with people. We'll talk a little bit more about what we call netiquette, being polite and respectful, but certainly you can ask other classmates questions or perhaps disagree with what they're saying, obviously, and like we said, in a respectful manner. Forward your own views regarding these things, but the idea that you will post a discussion board response as well as respond to two other classmates' discussion board responses. And then the last part of a typical module will be submission of an essay question. So we go here, and there's a picture of a Dropbox here. You can actually go into the essay. Again, it'll be pretty clearly spelled out what it is that I would like you to research and discuss. You are free to use your texts as well as draw citations from the text or other sources to develop your answer to the weekly essay. And then when you are completed with it, you are able, just with one button, to submit it directly to the Dropbox. It'll come directly to me for grading. We'll also take a look real quickly at if we go back to start here, we can take a look at the essay rubric. The idea basically, again, that this is how those essays will be graded. There are five criteria. You can get 0, 1, or 2 points in each of those five criteria. Clearly, your best bet is to go for the 2 points, which says basically content. All of these criteria, insight that you've demonstrated an understanding to me in, and the ability to demonstrate to me that you understand that you do use citations from the text to support your essay, spelling and grammar, and appearance. And if you get all those points, that's obviously a 10-point essay, and then obviously down the line here. So close that out. Back to, let's say, the weekly module we were talking about. So if we're starting again here in module one, you can clearly see that then you will read the assignment, formulate your response, and then submit it via the Dropbox, where it'll be graded according to the rubric. And then at the end of every module is a checklist. So if you're wondering whether or not you've gotten everything done, you can go through here and use these checks. These will be clear for you. Materials for each section, then you would be able to check them all. So that is, again, we're starting here. You can see clearly we've already discussed some of these. Other materials that are in here are in the start here section, questions about how to use D2L, as well as getting technology help from the college, and also resources available to you here at the college. Tutoring library services is also a link to the course LibGuide, which is assistance from the library, and how to access our embedded librarian, which I'll discuss in another section. If we go back, there we go, again so there's the discussion boards. Again, we have just general questions about the research evaluation assignment. We'll discuss in another video. Once again, you can post questions directly to the librarian, our embedded librarian for this course, as well as the selection. Now, these will not all be unlocked like this in yours. They'll become unlocked as the course progresses. Once again, the Dropbox is right here. You can see Dropboxes for each of the major assignments during the semester. Once again, quizzes will become available to you as not only the course progresses, but as you watch the lecture videos. modules has a quiz with 10 points. Each of the module has a discussion board with 10 points, and each of the modules has essays worth 10 points. And during the course of the semester, we'll be taking two exams during the semester itself, each covering half of the material, half of the modules, and then a final exam at the